last video. Okay, so that costume that I just showed y'all on part one, it's gonna be like a little series type of ordeal. This is part two. This is Selena's Astrodome kind of makeup look. I know I look crazy, like I'm from an African tribe. My like highlight and contouring all in one right now, using YBF and the products that I showed y'all from the last video. The color stick. It's a good highlighter. My hands are like all crazy right now because I have like colors, different colors. I didn't know which one to wear. Let's start blending now. Get all the white first. Well, all the... This is a pretty look, actually. I know it's gonna look really crazy. When you first do this, it always looks crazy, but it always comes out good. So what I was trying to say in part one about the ring finger, anyways, it's an artery vein that goes through it, which helps melt your makeup and like help blend it in through your skin and make everything look real pretty and blended and even. It's smooth and covered more better. And now, sorry. Okay, so anyways, you go back, blend all this in. All the white that I had up here, I went and blended all those in first. Now I'm gonna do the brown part. This is to make my face look rounder. I look like something off of Katy Perry's music video. It's just to make my face look and give the appearance more female, you know, yeah. And this big brown spot here, I bring it up to my temples all the time. I always bring this down because it makes my face feel or look slimmer whenever I do it. I'm sorry I'm not looking in the camera. I really can't see myself. Oh, y'all want to know how I did this bun? Isn't that cute? I just put it up like I was going to do it in a little bun. And I like put it on the buns like on top of my head. And I just pulled it this way instead of pulling it back and bend this way. I was recording, my camera wasn't even on. That sucked. The liner that I did on part one, it didn't come out as good as I thought it wanted or as I wanted it to. So this one I'm gonna do a little bit thinner. And hers usually stopped like right at the end of the eye. And it winged out just a little bit. So her eye was very, very simple. And just the inside was done with eyeliner. I'm gonna have to get close to a mirror. I'm sorry. I'm not gonna do that much powder on top. So above your natural crease, you wanna go in just with the brown. And hers kinda came out like this. And then it came up. And she focused, I noticed, like on her inner right here. Like hers did this ordeal. Instead of like, I don't know how most girls do their eye makeup like gets bigger up here than over here. Well, Selena's wasn't like that. She was like up here. Above your crease, okay? A darker brown to kind of wing it out. Okay? Kind of just whatever. Nothing major. You just get your blending brush and blend. Blend, blend. So, I didn't have enough brown right here. Hope y'all like keeping up with me. I know I'm kind of scatterbrained, but whatever. Work with me. How many more minutes? 16 minutes! Okay, then with your highlight, ooh! You're gonna just highlight your eyebrow bone really fast. I'm gonna set my face with a little bit of bronzer just because I feel like I'm a little glossy and white. I look very pale. Very simple. Oh my goodness, what is that? I always go back and just make it pop. Put a little bit of color in the inside. That's kind of like how she had it anyways. Okay. Just depth. It has a lot of depth in it. That's what you want to create. Very beautiful. Selena lip. My mustache. Mustache coming through to say hi. How y'all doing? And then go back with your brown and do some touch-ups. Oh, eyebrows. Okay, so with the same brown, whatever color you have, cut it in. And on Selena's last concert look, her eyebrows were more, her eyebrows were arched big time. and shaped. Very much so. And they weren't dark, so I don't know why I'm doing mine dark, but it's a Selena look. Okay? Anyways, you get the picture. Go back, shape your eyebrows. I'll be back. I'm gonna show you a whole outfit, and I'm gonna do a little dance or whatever for y'all. Cheekbones are not popping as loud as I thought, so I'm gonna go back with a little bit. She had some beautiful cheekbones. Jay say Jay does. Recreating her looks and stuff. I kind of just base them on her concerts and go back and look at all her concerts. YouTube has them all. I forgot to use primer. Go figure, my scattered ass today. Oh, and another thing. Whenever I show y'all the costume and stuff, I'll show y'all. But basically, I made my own hip pad out of poly foam from Hobby Lobby. I got a 3-inch one. I don't know what I was thinking on getting 3 inches of foam thickness, because I thought, I'm gonna have me some padding, you know, it's gonna look good. No. Found some shapes. I googled how to make hip pads. I made me some huge ones because I'm gaining a lot of weight, and I thought maybe I might need big pads to make me a bigger padding. If you're a drag queen, or if you're a tranny, or if you're a cross dresser or whatever, and you want to use like hip pads and stuff, you got to be careful, because if you're already a little thick, put on hip pads, and yes, they make you feel fatter than what you really are, but if you want the female shape, I think that is the way to go. Don't go wasting your money on 3 inches of freaking foam just to make the hip pads, because when you're cutting this out, it shrinks anyway. Like, it starts to shrink through the process of it getting, of making this thinner, it starts shrinking this thing. You might just want to buy 1-inch foam. Yes, I think that's it. Okay, so hi, I'm back with nails and a ghetto little top. I don't think I've ever really showed y'all my costume, like ever really just like opened it up in the inside or showed y'all just how it was made. I'm sweating, I'm hot. I don't know if y'all get dressed up, but if y'all do, if there's some little trannies or cross dressers on my page looking at this video, girl, I'm hot. I don't know about you, but I get hot when I dress up. This is my beautiful costume that I spent a freak load of money on, and I have all this tissue. I got it on this beautiful hanger. Look at this hanger. Isn't it pretty? Fluffy hangers I like. Reminds me of Mommy Dearest. Here's the inside. She did all the way, the inside, all the way into the sleeves of this silky material. First off, let me say this material is very, 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 very hard to find. I had to go onto a website that was like where schools pay to get cheerleader costume fabric and stuff like that. That's where I found this stuff at. It wasn't cheap. Bolero jacket. I love it. It's pretty. It doesn't really show good on this camera. Now that I'm looking at it, it's like, oh. The button. How the buttons are put on. She just put a little bracket like this on there. And then on the opposite side, on the outside, is this slit, so when you put it on, clips on really cute and decently. In the description, in the info bar or whatever, I'm gonna post who made this, her Yahoo review page and stuff. People give her good ratings. I personally, my personal experience with her was really nice. She's a sweet lady. I had to order, special order, shoulder pads. The shoulder pads are called saddleback shoulder pads. And why they're called saddleback, if you look at it, it kind of indents. It does like a little, and then up here is way more bigger than this side. Like, I don't know how to explain it. See how fat it is? And she did these huge flared legs, and they're huge flares, like really, really big. What I like about my Selena costume that's different from others that I have looked up and seen online and stuff, mine is just one solid strip. Like, there's no, you know, line here that sews the bell bottom to the pant. It's just one solid ordeal. See? Back, of course, she has a zipper. And right here, she has like this little clip thing in the inside of the pants. Clip it. And so it doesn't come undone. So you can zip it more better. And the zipper, you know, it's a 12-inch zipper thing. I had a friend who was super, super skinny put this on. I mean, this thing fits all sizes, really. You see how little it is? It looks like a little kid's ordeal, but it stretches like
same thing over your shoulder.
This one connects to this shoulder.
Okay, so this is the costume. These are the hip pads that I made, so...
Ibas a regresar y me ibas.